Okay, this song may be my favorite. We're only 35 seconds in, but I just love where it's been and where it's going. What is up, people? Welcome back to the Chocolate Man Fan Channel. I just recorded my reaction to the Sour album, and suffice to say, I love literally every single song. But I just wanted to film this introduction now, before that, just because, in case I wasn't clear in my previous introduction, basically, that's all you need to know. And hopefully you enjoy my reaction. What is up, people? Welcome back to the Chocolate Man Fan Channel. Today we're reacting to Olivia Rodrigo's Sour album. I wanted to react to it the day it came out, but it's just kind of hard to like set some time like for a full-on reaction. But I'm here now, and I'm actually really excited because I think... So, of the album so far, obviously I've listened to Driver's License, Deja Vu, Good For You. I just reacted to Favorite Crime yesterday, their live performance. I actually listened to Brutal... like once on the day it came out, and then Enough For You, I also reacted to her performance of that. Sorry, I'm just trying to catch up on what I've heard. I literally love all of her music, literally every song I've heard. The thing about Olivia Rodrigo, I don't know if I can like address her by her first name. I really like her music. I love emotional pop songs because like I grew up with my sisters, and that's kind of a lot of the music that we listened to growing up, and so that's kind of what I'm used to, and that's where, like, I just like that music, and I think she delivers a lot of emotional music, and I really appreciate that. I think she's super honest and open with her feelings, and yeah, I just really like her music, so we're gonna start off listening to Brutal, then Traitor, then One Step Forward, Three Steps Back, then Happier, then Jealousy, then Hope You're Okay, because those are the songs I haven't listened to, except for Brutal, which I think I have heard, but I just wanted to hear again. So yeah, let's just get into this. Something in a musical so far. Oh yeah, okay. I remember this song perfectly now. So like, yeah, I've heard this song. I even like looked at the lyrics and everything on the first day. I love this song. It's like, it's basically her venting, venting all of her kind of frustration and pain, and I really like the song, especially like the chorus, which is, I love this chorus. It feels like she's almost like yelling at society, complaining, and like almost it feels like most of her songs, I love when she swears, because it's like, it's kind of unexpected for me, like, to just hear swears in music, because I listen to a lot of K-pop and stuff, and of the music I listen to, I actually don't hear swear, like, bad words, quote-unquote bad words, often, so it is quite rare for me to hear that stuff. But yeah, I really love it when she swears in her music, I don't know why.
It's brutal out here.
Oh, I love when she speaks as well in her music. It feels like her music is almost like her sharing her opinions and thoughts with the world, to the world. And it just started raining, how freaking perfect, okay. So let's just get into the next song. So I haven't heard Traitor before ever, so. I wonder if the drizzling's gonna make me really, really sad listening to some of these songs. Oh my god, there's so much emotion in this song. What I really like about her music is, especially here, it's not like a lot going on, but what she's very careful, I feel, her with like the other people who produce her music as well with her. I think what they do is they always pick like basically instrumental music to really create such emotion. And even here, like at the before the chorus, everything else leading up was very like slow, and you've really caught that mood that she's going for, and yeah, she nailed it basically. Now you bring her around just to shut me down, show her off like she's a new trophy. And I feel like her lyrics almost like a stream of her consciousness. I think that's why it's so real, and I think that's why so many people connect to her and like her music. Like that line just there where she said, "You told me I'm paranoid," and like those kind of thoughts are like, it's just so like refreshingly real, I feel, for someone to sing about that stuff. You're still a traitor. She uses these silences so well. Like here, like the silence you just had there before, what I'm guessing this bridge is, that was so well used. And she does it in like a lot of her music. Like even in Good For You, which is like one of my favorite songs of hers. This, I think she uses the silence before the like a sociopath line, I think, maybe. I love these harmonies. God, I love her voice. She always sings with so much emotion. I say that every time I listen to her sing. But it's also like, I don't even think she's like reached her full potential yet. And she's just like playing around with her voice. Like there we got the harmonies, and then we got that like really high note at the end. And I just, yeah, I like how you're getting different elements of her voice. And yeah, I just really like that. This is one step forward, three steps back. Called you on the phone today. Just to ask you how you are. Again, here, this is exactly what I'm talking about. She sings so delicately. It's almost like she's singing to the person, like on the phone or something, like quietly. See, it's just. Whenever she swears, it like it throws me off. Myself so much. But it's real. It's real. That's how anyone would sing that speak. I really, really love this song. This is probably like the most low-key song of hers I've heard, where it's just like a piano, I think. And I really love this. It almost feels like there's no structure. It feels like she's just letting things out. But then when you hear the repetition of like the chorus, then I kind of like remember, hey, it's a song. But yeah, I really, really like this song. This entire song, this entire song she sang, I can't even speak. That entire song she sang in that kind of like whispery area, and it sounded so good. Like, I said it so many times, so I'm not gonna repeat, but yeah, it just sounded amazing there. This is Happier. I really like this song. Ah! Again, I love what she swears, but I also love this song so far. It's the way she sings, it kind of feels not normal. It feels like she's speak singing, you know? Like, the way she used Happier in that chorus, especially as the last word, it felt like something I didn't expect there. Basically, I love how it sounds. That's what I'm trying to say. This makes me feel like, this kind of gives me like Thinking Out Loud, but way sadder vibes. I don't know why, but this is kind of how it's like making me feel. This is probably the saddest song I've heard from her, because she's literally like saying how your quote unquote new girl, I don't know if I did that weird. My fingers are weird. She basically said, like, your new girl's amazing, and she probably gives you butterflies or whatever, and you can be happy with them, but please don't be happier with her than you were with me. And, like, it's almost like she's, like, in theory, like, admitting that she may be better than her, you know? And that's why it's like so sad, because she's literally singing that. And so yeah, this feels like the, even though it's not as slow tempo, not as like melancholic, I feel, the music wise as the other songs, the lyrics really like hit home here. Oh, the production of this song is just the production of this song is unbelievably good. Again, another song where there's never a dull moment, and they always introduce things at the end of like each section. She's almost too talented. I don't know where her niche is, because where she best excels, because this music, these slower tracks with so much emotion and within the lyrics and music, she excels here. But then also with like, I really really love Good For You, like I really love that song, so it's like, is that where she excels? But like, she does so well here. She just, yeah, she's crazy talented. This is jealousy. I have a feeling this is gonna be. Okay, we're 11 seconds in. Ooh, we're 11 seconds in. I already love this song. I love the bass. Be true. Okay, this song may be my favorite. We're only 35 seconds in, but I just love where it's been and where it's going. Production of this track is so exciting. It feels I love this song. Okay, before we get on to whatever the bridge is of this masterpiece, I love how it's changed so much, like between the verses and the chorus musically, but also the use of like different like vocal patterns and stuff and harmonies. Oh, this song. It feels like this will almost turn into like Good For You. It's like Good For You's like younger sister or brother. A much more mellow version of Good For You. Okay, so far, Jealousy is my favorite song. You were a boy once when I was small. A tow-head blonde with eyes of salt. You played the drum in the marching band. Parents cared more about the Bible than being good to their own child. He wore long sleeves because of his dad. And somehow he fell out of touch. Hope he took his bad deal and made a royal flood. Of this song are so powerful and so, I think this is the saddest song on the album now, like wow, that first verse was just insanely almost tragic. Middle school friend grew up at home. She raised her brothers on her own. Her parents hated who she loved. She couldn't wait to go to college. She was tired because she was brought into a world where family was merely blood. She know how proud I am. She was created.
with the courage to unlearn all of the hatred. We don't talk much, but I just gotta say, I miss you. I hope that you're okay. I just love
you. Oh my god. Okay, before we get into the bridge of this song is, I think this was written from such a compassionate, emotional, honest place that you're hearing, like, stories. I don't know if these are true stories, obviously, but they feel really real and, like, super sad. And I feel like this kind of shows, and I'm just guessing here, I think it shows how much of a good, caring, and compassionate person she is that she's released a song like this on her debut album, because this is really, it's almost tough to listen to the kind of struggles her friends, or not even friends, I don't know, these like even strangers, it seems like she's not in contact with them anymore. Well, at least within the song, I don't know anything. But yeah, this is a very real, striking song. What are these sounds? I don't know what the sounds of at the end of this song were. They were like muffled and sound like people speaking, a male and maybe a female. But she just started doing her Q&A on Twitter, and someone asked like what are her family's favorite songs, and she said her parents' favorite song was this, Hope You're Okay, I think. God, I look really stupid if that's not what she just said. But I think that is what she just said. I forgot. I completely understand if they even like know these people who are in this song or whatever. This is probably the most meaningful song she's written. I'm just guessing, because it feels so unfiltered and so real and so like uncovered. And I was thinking of before, like that last section with those muffled like sounds or whatever, it was really, the instrumental was super, almost felt like basic, but her lyrics and like the song and everything, all it comes together, it's so much more than just like instrumental. This is the perfect example of how lyrics I feel can change a song. God, it seems like I'm like being like dismissive of the music. I'm not, but I'm saying I feel like the lyrics really like made the song transcend to like another like level emotionally, especially when you hear it for like the first time, like I just did. Like basically, damn, you know, like that really hits home. I don't know, but oh, is that it? Oh, that's it. Okay, I just listened to that song, that entire album. I've heard every single song from that album. I don't even have words. This is such a beautiful album because it goes different places. Like it's not just about like love and heartbreak and stuff, although the majority is, I feel. But like hope you're okay really has like struck a nerve within me. That song really, that song is something else. Personally, my favorite song, I don't know, I love all of her singles. I love Good For You. I love Driver's License. The bridge of Driver's License is the best bridge I've heard this year. Jealousy, Jealousy, I love listening to just now. Good For You, I just love Good For You. Hope You're Okay is, it's made me feel something that none of the other songs made me feel. Maybe, no, I think Happier also, really. I don't know. I basically, as you can tell, I'm torn. A lot of these songs I really love. Even Brutal. Yeah, I don't really know what else to say. Like, this is a really amazing album. I love literally all the music from it. I love her artistic choices within her music as well. Hope You're Okay is just is that song for me. I don't know what it is. Something about that song. I just listened to it the first time and like it resonated with me so much, and I don't even know why. But yeah, that was a really emotional song. I really like Jealousy. I don't know what I'm saying. I've already gone through the songs I like. Anyway, yeah, I don't know what else to say. She's super talented. This is literally just the beginning of her career, which, like, I think we feel also lucky we're living in this time. So yeah, that's it, I guess. Hopefully you enjoyed my reaction. Please let me know your thoughts, your favorite songs of the off the album. What do you think about her debut? Yeah, what do you think about Sour? Let me know down in the comments below. I'll try and interact with you, hopefully, if anyone does comment. But yeah, we'll see you next time on the Chocolate Man Fan Channel.